everyone, this is Jemima from Bombitool Supply Agency Private Limited, India. In this vlog, I'll be discussing on the various tips and the right way to use a caliper.
In machine shops, the term caliper is more often used when compared to a micrometer. There are various types of calipers, but they are designed the same way. Let me explain the parts of a caliper. These are the outer jaws, the inside jaws, locking screw, thumb wheel, beam, main scale, vernier scale, step measuring phases, and depth bar.
A variety of factors can cause errors when measuring with a caliper. Major factors include parallax effects, excessive measuring force due to the fact that a caliper does not conform to the Obeys principle, differential thermal expansion due to the temperature difference between the caliper and the workpiece, the effect of the thickness of the knife edge jaws and the clearance between these jaws during measuring a small hole. Although there are also other error factors such as graduation accuracy, reference edge straightness, main scale flatness on main blade, the squareness of the jaws. These factors are included within the instrumental error tolerances. Therefore, these factors do not cause any problem as long as the caliper satisfies the instrumental error tolerances. Take care when you measure it with the root or the tip of the jaws, because a large error could occur in such cases. We very often come across this word parallax error. What is parallax error? Parallax is the displacement or difference in the apparent position of an object viewed along two different lines of sight. For example, our human eye has two different lines of sight viewing on the same object. The process by which the brain exploits the parallax is due to the different views from our eye to gain depth perception and estimate distances to objects, or simply speaking, the error or displacement caused in the apparent position of an object due to the viewing angle, that is, other than the angle perpendicular to the object.
For example, when reading the scale, look straight at the vernier graduation line when checking the alignment of vernier graduation line to the main scale graduation lines. If you look at the graduation line from an oblique direction A, the apparent alignment position is distorted by delta x as shown in the figure. Due to this effect caused by the step height h between the planes of the vernier graduations and the main scale graduations, resulting in a reading error of the measured value. To avoid this error, the step height should be more than 0.3 mm. Initially, we are going to check the zero measurement. When we close our jaws, we can see some gap. This is not the place to measure. The closed portion is the jaw area where we should measure. There are basic three things in the jaws of the caliper, that is, the inside groove area, machined area, and the edge of the jaws. Always use constant force. Make sure that you are not giving too much force or too little force. This might affect the measurement. Too much of force can damage the part, and too little force gets insufficient contact with the part to be measured and gives a wrong measurement. If moving jaw becomes tilted out instead of parallel with the fixed jaw, either through excessive force being used on the slider or lack of straightness in the reference edge of the beam, the measurement error will occur as shown in figure. Clean the contact points or the jaws using a lint-free cloth before measuring. We can also grip a lint-free paper between the outside jaws and then slowly pull it out. After cleaning, we can close the jaws and see towards the light and can make sure that light does not pass through the jaws. If light passes through, there may be parallelism error and has to be repaired. In internal jaws, a small amount of light will be shining through and the edges should be clean without burrs. Ensure that the sliding jaw moves smoothly over the length of the beam. Due to step and height of the vernier scale relative to main scale, if viewing direction is not directly above the reading, it may lead to parallax error. Initially, set the zero setting of the caliper. If not, it will lead to abrupt results. Make sure that measurements are not taken on the edge of the jaws. Instead, take the measurement on the machined area and preferably on the top, which will give better consistency, accuracy, and repeatability. Let's see how to take reading on a metric vernier caliper. Caliper jaws are sharp. Therefore, the instrument must be handled with care to avoid personal injury. You can also use vernier caliper stands for stability. For this demonstration, I have used a Jeffegy vernier caliper stand. The least count of the caliper is 0.02 mm. It has both mm and inches scale. Do not read the reading on the starting of the caliper. It will give wrong results. Instead, read from the line that represents zero. The graduation lines on the main scale denote 1 mm each. The longer graduation line on the vernier scale represents 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 and so on. Each small line represents 0.02, 0.04, 0.06, 0.08 and so on the vernier scale. I will also show you how to measure using external jaws, internal jaws, step measuring faces and depth bar. Now let's measure the value on the caliper using external jaws. As you can see, the value on the main scale is 30 mm. On the vernier scale, check which line is coinciding with the lines on the main scale. Here, it's 0.62 mm. So the final reading is 30.62 mm. Now let's measure a component. Try to find out the value of the component measured. I will wait for you to calculate the reading. The main scale reads 22 mm and the vernier scale reads 0.36 mm. Hence the value is 22.36 mm. Vernier calipers require good eyesight or magnifying glass to read it correctly. It is difficult to read from a distance and also from different angles. It is relatively easy to misread the last digit. Let's now measure the width of this component using the internal jaws. While measuring with the internal jaws, insert the jaw as deeply as possible before measurement. Read the maximum indicated value. Here, the value is 9.52 mm. In different orientations, it is very difficult for the user to read the values on the vernier caliper. It is relatively easier to read in a dial caliper when compared to a vernier caliper. The least count of this dial caliper is 0.02 mm. So every graduation line in the dial represents 0.02 mm. And every line on the main scale represents 1 mm. Let's measure this component. First, read the main scale reading, which is 22 mm, and now read the dial face reading, which is 0.30 mm. So the total reading is 22.30 mm. We can also set the dial to 0 at any position to take a comparative reading. Let's now measure a component using digital caliper. When compared to the vernier and dial caliper, it is very easy to use a digital caliper. If you have replaced the battery or if you are going to insert the battery for the first time, the display will show a blank screen. Reset the origin button by pressing the origin button, which is usually done with the jaws closed. Press until the display shows zero. The encoder allows the caliper to maintain the reference value even when the caliper is turned off. The reference value is saved until the battery is removed. Digital calipers can switch easily from mm to inches. Close the jaws and ensure that the vernier scale or the display reads zero before taking the measurement. The least count of this caliper is 0.01 mm. Now let's measure the component. The value of this component is 22.29 mm. We can set the caliper to 0 at any position for a comparative reading. Now let's measure the depth of this component using a digital caliper. We can easily measure the depth of the hole that has a smaller diameter. The depth of this component is 13.28 mm. However, When I try to measure the depth of the hole with a bigger diameter, my caliper enters this hole, making it impossible for me to measure the depth. In such cases, we can use an additional accessory known as the depth gauge attachment. We can easily fix this attachment to any vernier caliper to check the depth. It becomes much easier to check the depth of a larger hole. Now let's measure the depth of the bigger diameter of this component using the same digital caliper. As you can see, I have attached the depth measuring accessory to the same caliper. Now my caliper is not entering the hole and can easily measure the hole of the larger diameter. The measured depth of this component is 30.93 mm. Now let's measure the step height of this component using step measuring faces. This is the step measuring face of the caliper with which we can measure the step height. Position the vernier on one step of the component and measure the height. The step height of this component is 2.58 mm. Avoid damaging the scale of a caliper and do not engrave any identification number or other information on it with an electrical marker pen. If the caliper is not going to be used for a longer time, then remove the battery. While storing a caliper, ensure that the measuring jaws are not in contact with each other so that the caliper can be protected from any damage.
Hope this information was useful. If you have any other doubts or questions related to a caliper, feel free to comment below and we will always be available to answer your questions. In the next video, let's discuss on the tips and usage of another instrument. Subscribe to our channel and visit our website www.btsa.in.